One, two. One, two. Good morning, DeMatha. Could I have your attention, please? Could I have your attention, please? I'd like to welcome all of you to our opening school liturgy. This is a very important part of who we are. And you might remember from years past what the returning students do. We give a warm welcome to the new class, the class of 2026. We clap them in so that they understand that brotherhood is not just a word we print up on brochures or we talk about it, but we actually demonstrate. So I'm going to ask all of us to stand and turn around, and when I give you the signal, I will say, welcome to the class of 2026, and I ask us to give them a continuous round of applause as they enter the Convocation Center. So you can let Mr. O'Connell know that we are ready, if they are ready. If one of the teachers would let them know. All right, men, please stand and turn around, but don't clap yet. Welcome to the class of 2026 to DeMatha. Welcome to the... Thank you.
Good morning, DeMatha. As Father James just said, my name is Michael Metz, and I'm your student government president for the 2022-2023 school year. So let me add my voice to the many who have already welcomed you back to school this year. This Mass sadly marks the end of our 75th anniversary celebration. Let us look with hope and confidence into the future as we work together to make DeMatha successful for many more years to come. Now let us all be attentive, respectful, and reverent as we celebrate this Mass, because we, as DeMatha men, that is what we do. Please know that SGA is here to support you and present your needs to all the administration. It is my hope that we will have a great year together. Now let us quiet our hearts and minds as we begin our opening Mass.
We are here today to praise our God, whom we know and love, is our Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This is the first gathering of the entire DeMatha community, and how appropriate our first gathering is here at prayer, because prayer is the foundation of our life here at DeMatha. One of the greatest blessings the Lord has, He always forgives when you and I have made mistakes. We are confident with His forgiveness, and so we say, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Creator of all, we gather before you today in prayer as we begin another academic year at the school named in honor of your servant, St. John DeMatha. We take some time today to pause and reflect on the great gift of Catholic education. We pause and reflect on the great people who make up the DeMatha community, faculty, staff, students, and families. Bless us today and throughout this new school year. And may we always rely on your grace so that we can pursue holy wisdom and learn what it means to be a faith-filled gentleman and scholar. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the master teacher and model for our lives, forever and ever. Can have an amen. Amen. Please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Sirach. If you wish, my son, you can be wise. If you apply yourself, you can be shrewd. If you are willing to listen, you can learn. If you pay attention, you can be instructed. Stand in the company of the elders. Stay close to whoever is wise. Be eager to hear every discourse. Let no insightful saying escape you. If you see the intelligent, seek them out. Let your feet wear away their doorsteps. Reflect on the law of the Most High, and let his commandments be your constant study. Then he will enlighten your mind and make you wise as you desire. The word of the Lord.
Lord, send out your spirit, and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send us your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, my soul, he is great indeed. He has made the creatures great and small. He has made the creatures great and small. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Blessed be the Lord, may his glory live. I will praise and glorify his name. I will praise and glorify his name. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Reading from St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians. For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you, in accord with the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to accomplish far more than all we ask or imagine by the power at work within us. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus said in reply, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. For our returning students, faculty, and staff, this prayerful gathering for Mass is something we remember every year. For our new campus faces, we engage in this change in schedule on September 9th every year to validate the fact that we are a faith-based school. And we believe that it is faith in God and faith in each other which are the pillars of our lives together at DeMatha. Now, we choose September 9th for this celebration every year. It is a weekday because on September 9th, 1946, 76 years ago now, DeMatha Catholic High School opened its doors for the first time. And when they opened the doors in 1946 on September 9th, we had an enrollment of 18 students and the faculty less than 10. Here we are today, 76 years later, on this September 9th, and we are beginning our school year with an enrollment of 821 students and a faculty and staff of over 120. DeMatha, we have much to celebrate, and at the center of the foundation is our belief that we are forming a brotherhood that will last forever. Yesterday, DeMatha completed its 75th anniversary year of the school's foundation, and for those of us who were together last year, it was quite a year, filled with assemblies and gatherings and celebrations and opportunities to reflect on where we have come from that small one-room school building in 1946 to a campus that has five entirely independent buildings. And we have also expanded our curricula opportunities. But men, we are more than numbers. We are more than numbers. We are a school with its posture centered on the belief that God loves us and centered on the belief we are created in his image. And one of our duties is to deepen this love and to create a community of brothers who will make a difference in our world today. And our culture today needs many men and women who are willing to believe that people are a valuable part of our life because we are all made in the image and likeness of God. Here in our school, we pray for each other, we assist each other, and we pledge to foster that sense of community and brotherhood and family for everyone. But why do we do this? Why make all this change? Why have a change in schedule? We do it because that is what a DeMatha man does. We help each other, we respect each other, and we do it because that is what Jesus asks from us. So we are now going to publicly demonstrate our faith connection. In a moment, we will bless each class as a group, and then after that, I will invite the faculty and staff to leave their places. They will come down the center aisle and form a line, a circle, and then down the center aisle. I will bless our faculty and staff for their commitment to foster the mission of the school, and then the officers of the Student Government Association will approach each teacher, fist bump, thank them for what they do to make DeMatha special, and give them a pin, which we ask them to wear. This is how DeMatha begins its year, with prayer and recognizing the individual components of our school. So now we will begin. I ask the seniors only to stand in their place, and I will impart a blessing for them. So seniors only, stand. Bow your heads in prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the leadership that is present in the senior class of DeMatha. May their final months of secondary education continue to shape their minds and hearts to know what you ask of them for the future. We need their enthusiasm,
We rely on their example, and we ask that you let them work closely as brothers under the banner of St. John DeMatha. May all our lives be enriched because of their 4 years with us, for we believe in them, and we believe in you as our Lord forever and ever. Seniors respond, amen. Please be seated. Now I ask the juniors to please stand, and Father Damien will impart a blessing.
I ask you to kindly bow your heads. Holy Spirit of wisdom and knowledge, we ask for your inspiration for the junior class of DeMatha. As they now assume upper class status in our school, continue to deepen within them a sense of courage, fortitude, and understanding as they begin to shape their thoughts and their plans for the future. Let them never forget their years here at DeMatha and the many voices who guide them and help them. Let your holy presence remain with them forever and ever. Will the junior class please respond, amen. Thank you, please be seated. Our sophomore class, please stand. Father Albert will offer the blessing.
Please bow your heads. O Holy Father, St. John DeMatha, we ask for your special blessing on the sophomore class of DeMatha. As they begin their second year with the DeMatha tradition, let them always realize the need they have to connect with you as our patron and to connect with the goodness and holiness you represent. Continue to shape them into faith-filled gentlemen and scholars so that others will come to see in them the values that you share with us in helping each other as brothers and serving the needs of all. Bless them with your courage, St. John DeMatha, forever and ever. Amen. Now I invite Father Josh to come and offer our freshmen their blessing. Please stand, freshmen.
Class of 2026, please bow your heads. God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we are grateful to you for this newest group of students at DeMatha. Sustain them in their choice to become part of the DeMatha tradition, and may they feel the brotherhood around them as they begin to create a sense of brotherhood among their class. Keep them safe and keep them motivated as they begin to understand and pursue what it means to be a man of action and a man of prayer in our school, dedicated to creating faith-filled gentlemen and scholars. We rely on your grace in their lives forever and ever. Freshmen, can I get an amen? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Please be seated.
I ask the faculty and staff now to leave their place, come down and start lining up next to the priests, and then down and down the center aisle. Thank you. I ask our faculty to bow their heads in prayer. Loving God of all people, we thank you for the faculty and staff who dedicate their lives to sharing wisdom with the men of DeMatha. Bless them with a deep sense of commitment to know the great call they have accepted to teach in our Catholic school. May the days they spend teaching, sharing, challenging, motivating, and understanding our students enrich their own lives and the lives of all whom they meet every day. Let this year be another example of courageous men and women sharing their hearts and minds with the next generation of men who will accept their gifts to improve the world around us. We are confident of your presence in all our lives, forever and ever in faculty and staff, amen. I will now bless the pins that the student government will give to each faculty member. Lord, bless these symbols of our dedication to Catholic education and bless those who will wear them. Always proud to be a member of the DeMatha community and to share the mission of Jesus in our teaching. And we ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand. Now we will now sing the chorus of our school song with our hands over our hearts, pledging that DeMatha is part of us and we are part of DeMatha. As our faculty return to their place, please acknowledge our faculty with a round of applause. Now that we have been nourished by the word of God and by celebrating our brotherhood and membership in DeMatha, let us place our needs before the Lord.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all world leaders that they may seek peaceful solutions to their We pray for all world leaders that they may seek peaceful solutions to their conflicts and always be mindful of the well-being of their citizens. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all students in the DeMatha community, past and present, especially for all freshmen and transfer students, that they may feel welcomed. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our school in thanksgiving for the past 75 years, and we look with hope to the future and ask God to bless our school administrators, teachers, staff, coaches, student leaders, that they may be guided by the tradition of St. John DeMatha as they strive to form us into faith-filled gentlemen and scholars. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our families who support and love us. May God grant them health and happiness in the coming year, and may we always be mindful and thankful of their love for us. We pray to the Lord. We pray for ourselves, that our heart may be open to receive the gift of wisdom from the Holy Spirit as we begin a new school year. Let us be guided by that wisdom in all that we do. We pray to the Lord.
Loving God, we are grateful for this moment when we gather together. Continue to inspire us to be people of faith who are willing to deepen our faith and share it with others. And we ask all this through Christ our Lord. Have an amen. Please be seated. Pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, we present these gifts to you so that they may nourish us with life-giving food and renew us with your holy sacraments. Grant that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts.
By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support. So that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory. And so with the angels, archangels, with a great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Wilton, our Bishop, and all women and men who minister in your church.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John DeMatha, St. Felix of Valois, St. Josaphat, Bishop and Martyr of Ukraine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Sing together. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Unites all of us as God's people, no matter what church we call home, is the Lord's Prayer. And so now let us pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now with a fist bump only, let us please share with each other a sign of Christ's peace. For the reception of Holy Communion or a blessing, I remind everyone to bow when you are number 2 in line, and please do not leave your place until the usher directs you to the communion station. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Please be seated.
I have heard you calling in my name.
Before we have our concluding prayer, on behalf of the assembly, I'd like to acknowledge Coach Turk and the voices of DeMatha and Father Josh in campus ministry, and for all the volunteer readers, servers, Eucharistic ministers, please acknowledge their generosity to the community. And let us pray. God, Father of all people, we are ready to continue another year of education with our DeMatha brothers and our DeMatha faculty. We thank you for your inspiration which brought us here and for your grace which keeps us here. May the days ahead be moments when we deepen our belief that we are your instruments of peace and hope in a very troubled world. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.